yesterday or the day before in which Slardar just gets on top of her and blows her up later.
You're legitimately dead.
They grabbed it this time, so they have this anti-healing hero. And I want to quickly talk about something else after 33 has died in this top lane.
All right, okay. He's happy with that.
Up dead here. Oh, there's the level twos.
Here we go. As soon as you say it, they've got that combination ready to go. They're trying to chase now. Nico Baby get on top of them. They find the crush. A few more hits with the bash will prime it up. And Nico Baby's been separated, pops a fairy fire. But he's now away from the rest of his supports. There's no backup for him.
Oh, he wants the stun. So he'll get the stun.
And at this point of the game, as we're seeing, you know, top lane.
Oh, okay. Fuck, in trouble as well.
Ooh, they lose 33. He's going to go for the quick trip back to base as he dies there to the neutrals. We'll see. Down bottom.
Liquid can either choose to match or beat your bottom lane, so.
And they go.
There's the damage.
Yeah, Foxy level 3, so he does now have the bash skilled. I mean, Liquid, these side lanes working heavily in the favor, in the mid lane as well, quite fair. He dives in aggressive with the ult. There's no help for Lim. Maneuvers keep themselves safe mid lane. 33 is trying to run this down, but Quifa's got the static link. 33 is not going to have the damage to get this kill, and with the TP over from Mikkei, 33 is definitely going to go down here. They get the nukes out, and 33 behind the tower here. They've got the four of them. They know that they're very strong at the moment, Liquid, that they get in onto the 33
Tiger?
Now. The TPs will come out. Tiger into the trees, gets himself away from the tower. Limbs come in, but Fada's already fallen. Quifa gets the first kill, and they're even poking and potentially more. Boxy starts to cut through the trees. Little careful though with Limp around and that Arcane Rune. He's got a lot of control and damage to hit out. As Liquid will back off. Happy with just the one kill.
To solve the defensive capability of the Omni Knight, just through mana burn, make them unable to fight. There's the exact relocate play coming in. They got Boxy and Avenge stun. He's pretty fast though, he will die eventually.
Yeah, they've got the missile coming in his way.
I've got his courage, too.
There's no backup for Boxy, so there's the moves you're talking about, Alliance. They've got to look for these opportunities and take advantage of them every single time.
For them now, this is playable. They have relocate 5 seconds.
Set up, they're looking to blow up Boxy. They're in on top of them. GA's out, Boxy will fall. They do lose Limp for it. Ice Blast and the full focus of Mikkei onto the Lina. Mikkei's going to look to try and set up for more. Fada swaps himself over deeper. Liquid will chase. Fada will fall as well. Mikkei getting involved.
Take one fight and now you're just farming. So I don't know if that was really value enough. Good Ice Blast, stun.
Set up, Nico Baby focus with the relocates there to take him out. We'll be able to leave him in the base. Unless they want to try and bring him in as the Ice Blast wears off and try and turn this. He's going to start healing up. He's just going to go for the TP to the tower. He wants to start returning to the fight from the tier 1 Hanscan. Tries to tether across. He gets crushed. They'll look to burst him, but the mech's popped. Hanscan, he's going to be fine for now. Liquid cannot kill even the Io there on the front. He's just too tanky, even at this stage of the game.
And well, Fada struggling. Oh,
they are going to try and come in here onto Nico Baby. Hanscan is going to provide some safety. Does not have the ability to take him out, though. The relocate will not be there in time to help as Hanscan's hold in place.
Not let them up, and they have to find another way into the fight.
Oh, again, they find the jump. They're in onto 33. There's going to be the buyback from 33, in fact. He's TPing in. Aggressively trying to see if they can maybe fight back onto Liquid, but Liquid, as soon as they see that buyback, they're out of there.
Currently turning into toast. Very frozen toast, but you know.
But Liquid have been very good at making sure that he doesn't get away with it.
He got the morph off. They tried so hard. This can get really nasty now.
Ice Blast. It's in onto Limp. Limp tries to turn, but there's quite for committing with the BKB. GA is popped, but Limp, the magic damage far too much as this Lina will fall. Nico Baby is taken out in time by Hanscan. Fada's also being watched by Tiger. So Liquid again finding cores. It's still so hard for Alliance to fight them. Liquid just off the back of the lanes. They are too far ahead. And Alliance, they struggle to take fights head on at all. Liquid, they'll go into the pit and with the Corrosive Haze, this will be an easy Rosh Tram for them. No opportunity for Alliance to come for a steal. This Aegis will be theirs.
And it's going to be a full heal for Mikkei here as well. He had the Vampire Fangs. He's going to pass them on now to the Slardar. Swapping in his own Morbid Mask. And now he's going to grab Aegis as well. Looking very, very stable here for Liquid this game. They haven't really tripped up at all since they got that big advantage. Condition you have, and then execute that limb.
Ooh, the heals. Ice Blast is there to swap. Fada will save him. Gets him out of the way. Big swap from Fada will cost him his life, but it keeps Limp alive.
Yeah, they didn't have Omni nearby, so Fada has to sacrifice himself. A four staff would have sufficed there as well. The exec play just happened, but they weren't ready. They're just not ready for these moves from Liquid. And they, I mean, look at the map, right? You have probably access to about a third of the map right now as Alliance, and that's not going to do. You have to make a move, and the move will be extremely difficult to make, but it has to be done.
And they're coming top, Liquid. They're looking to fight this. They're looking for an eco baby, but Hanskin's prepared.
He got missiled. All right, whee!
I mean, I don't think they're going to move down. Well, maybe they are, because Tiger and Boxy are close.
Whee! Oh, okay.
We're going to watch Hanskin. He's going to die and relocate. It's going to hit.
Bonk.
Okay. Does Boxy want to try and do something? I mean, him and Tiger, they're eyeing this up. The Overgrowth.
Oh, Omni.
Into the hammer. The Tiger does get burst, and Alliance, they're now going to turn towards Boxy. Boxy, he's got Mikkei nearby. Nico Baby bursts low enough to pop. Mikkei cleans up the kill, and Liquid, they're hunting for more. Limp in the trees. Light Strike holds back the Slardar, but Mikkei, he's punching just too hard at the moment right now. Limp cannot withstand this amount of physical damage as Liquid, from the top lane to the bottom lane, they continue to just kill them all.
Omni had to heavily grace himself to break the Overgrowth. It was really important there from Taiga to get it on both of them so that Omni can't just go and save his core. And then after that, the fight kind of just played itself there. Morphling just coming in, huge damage. Imagine if he had an E-Blade. He doesn't even. Like, the Lina still, the amount of damage that's coming out just from Adaptive Strike itself. This does not look good for Alliance. Oh, and I don't really see it.
Now,
there's an Aegis
push
on the morph.
There's tier 3's falling. And they cannot push them back. The tier 3, it's gone. Liquid can back off, get the shrines, continue to play it safe. There's a 15k lead. This game looking incredibly grim for Alliance, as you can see with the way that the net worth's going. There's not even any sort of signs of it being knocked back in Alliance's favor. They just have been unable to make any sort of play. Boxy's going to also have a completed BKB. So the idea of killing any of these cores on Liquid seems impossible for Alliance right now.
Bar to bottom, and this should be a kill. Morph comes in.
I mean, they're stepping out, Alliance. They land the Light Strike, but he's already shifting into Strength, so there's no follow-up. They had to retreat. Now, you can see, at least for the moment, Alliance still having the confidence to leave the base and try and chase up any kills, as they know that Liquid, they're going to be playing slightly, you know, sort of greedy and cocky, and will be shoving out lanes alone. And finding them picked off and split up, it's going to be a lot easier than trying to deal with them when Liquid come pushing in as five.
Unfortunately, one of the pushing heroes is a Treant that has Dagger, and that is a hero that their lineup can't really realistically catch. Really difficult mid lane. Yeah.
I mean, and here it is. They're just going to step up to the high ground, hit onto the Rax. What can they do to stop this? This is a Morphling with an Aegis and a whole lot of farm. And he goes, takes the Heavenly Grace once more. Another stun. They're trying to bring him down once. They will do so. They had to use the Laguna, though. Is there any sort of burst to allow them to have a chance of doing it again? The swap back, he's deep, but he gets the melee racks, gets out of there. There's no further catch from Alliance. Liquid, they got what they came for.
Fata did have a secondary swap, but I think they just identified they can't kill him a second time. You used Laguna. He was already morphing into full strength. It's not happening. And while this maybe could have gone a bit better for Alliance, or for Liquid, at the same time, the Aegis was running out. This is when it would have expired, so you kind of got good value out of it. You got a melee Rax, you got the Shrine. You're in control. You can choose now to play for the next Aegis, or you can try to find a decisive team fight. Any team fight win for Liquid right now is probably game over. Oh, double damage. Boy, look at that. Morphling, one of the best heroes in the game to find this rune on, has ridiculous base damage from morphing all of it into agility. Currently hits for 550, almost. Not bad.
Well, poor old Fada. TP on cooldown. He's not got anywhere really to go.
All right, let's see it. I want to see the one shot. Hit him. Oh okay. Boring.
I mean, he's doing his job though, Fada. He's taking the attention away from the mid lane. He's pushing out.
The classic 29-27 bounty rune. Don't see those a lot at this level of play.
I was going to say, it must have been totally ignored down there.
Yep.
I guess no one's really been out in that area.
Yeah, they haven't needed to go.
But look what we have on Alliance. They do have the repair kits in.
Yay!
Let's see if that is going to be enough to keep this going.
That's a good
Boxy. It's going to start off the action, plus the BKB. He's looking to split Hanskin away from Nico Baby. Nico Baby tried for the TP out, but Mikkei was in with the stun. They'll get the both of them. This is no escape from Liquid. You cannot come out on this map and expect to get home alive. Liquid will find you.
And this is super good timing too. They get the kills right after they have both outposts and all four bounty runes to claim at minute 30.
A 21k lead. I mean, this is it. It looks very, very much impossible for Alliance to swing this one around. Where's that repair kit? Nobody's stepping up and using it. I guess they're scared of Boxy coming in with a cross. It's in it. He could drop it from his backpack. I mean, at the moment, Nico Baby's just holding the backpack. He needs to drop it and give it to his teammates. But the racks, they're just going to be gone. Another set of racks starting to be up. They're just going to call it. They're just going to call it. GG is called. This one's all Liquid, and it really was just all Liquid. Every single lane, it went their way. I bet people were ready to laugh at them letting the IO through a second time, but Liquid, they proved they had a brilliant answer. Their lane set up, that aggressive tri lane, and the fact that Mikkei, he just got away with the freest start he's ever had on a mall. An entire lane to himself with nobody.